Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين حاميم والكتاب المبين إنا أنزلناه في ليلة مباركة إنا كنا منذرين فيها يفرق كل أمر حكيم أمرا من عندنا إنا كنا مرسلين رحمة من ربك إنه هو السميع العليم رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما إن كنتم موقنين لا إله إلا هو يحيي ويميت ربكم ورب آبائكم الأولين بل هم في شك يلعبون فارتقب يوم تأتي السماء بدخان مبين يغشى الناس هذا عذاب أليم ربنا اكشف عنا العذاب إنا مؤمنون أنى لهم الذكرى وقد جاءهم رسول مبين ثم تولوا عنه وقالوا معلم مجنون إنا كاشف العذاب قليلا إنكم عائدون يوم نبطش البطشة الكبرى إنا منتقمون ولقد فتنا قبلهم قوم فرعون وجاءهم رسول كريم أن أدوا إلي عباد الله إني لكم رسول أمين وأن لا تعلوا على الله إني آتيكم بسلطان مبين وإني عذت بربي وربكم أن ترجمون وإن لم تؤمنوا لي فاعتزلون فدعا ربه أن هؤلاء قوم مجرمون فأسر بعبادي ليلا إنكم متبعون واترك البحر رهوا إنهم جند مغرقون كم تركوا من جنات وعيون وزروع ومقام كريم ونعمة كانوا فيها فاكهين كذلك وأورثناها قوما آخرين فما بكت عليهم السماء والأرض وما كانوا منظرين ولقد نجينا بني إسرائيل من العذاب المهين من فرعون إنه كان عاليا من المسرفين ولقد اخترناهم على علم على العالمين وآتيناهم من الآيات ما فيه بلاء مبين إن هؤلاء ليقولون إن هي إلا موتتنا الأولى وما نحن بمنشرين فأتوا بآبائنا إن كنتم صادقين أهم خير أم قوم تبع والذين من قبلهم أهلكناهم إنهم كانوا مجرمين وما خلقنا السماوات والأرض وما بينهما لاعبين ما خلقناهما إلا بالحق ولكن أكثرهم لا يعلمون الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين إن يوم الفصل ميقاتهم أجمعين يوم لا يغني مولى عن مولى شيئا ولا هم ينصرون إلا من رحم الله إنه هو العزيز الرحيم إن شجرة الزقوم طعام الأثيم كالمهل يغلي في البطون كغلي الحميم خذوه فاعتلوه إلى سواء الجحيم ثم صبوا فوق رأسه من عذاب الحميم ذق إنك أنت العزيز الكريم إن هذا ما كنتم به تمترون إن المتقين في مقام أمين في جنات وعيون يلبسون من سندس وإستبرق متقابلين كذلك وزوجناهم بحور عين يدعون فيها بكل فاكهة آمنين لا يذوقون فيها الموت إلا الموتة الأولى ووقاهم عذاب الجحيم فضلا من ربك ذلك هو الفوز العظيم فإنما يسرناه بلسانك لعلهم يتذكرون فارتقب إنهم مرتقبون الله أكبر
بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه In which Sheikh Othman beautifully recited Surah Dhukhan, and Surah Dhukhan is one of the amazing surahs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala touches upon so many different aspects that we need to learn and reflect upon. And something for us, perhaps inshallah, when we go home, when we have a bit of time later on today, it would be good for us to read up on the surah because it is very, very powerful. And in the surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the terrors of the hereafter, about the people of Jahannam. About the punishment that they will receive, the punishment that they'll be told, taste the fire, taste this punishment because of what they used to earn. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He normally says, He gives a fire exit and gives the people of Jannah and the fadl and the bounties that they'll have. But this concept of the Akhirah, we recited it in the first rak'ah of Taraweeh tonight as well, in Surah Furqan. And wallahi, my brothers, these were serious verses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He talks about the conversations that are going to take place. The conversations that are going to take place in the hereafter. And some of these conversations, especially the second one that's mentioned, is every time I read it, brothers, this is something that is something that hits home. Allah SWT tells us in Surah Al-Furqan, وَيَوْمَ يَعَضُّ الظَّالِمُ, that the one, the oppressor, he'll bite at his hands. He'll gnaw at his hands in the hereafter. And he'll say, shame on me, shame on me. يَا لَيْتَنِ اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ الرَّسُولِ سَبِيلًا. Shame on me, because I took another path away from what the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, from the Messenger, what he was telling me to do. And he'll say, shame on me. يَا لَيْتَنِي اتَّخَذْتُ مَعَ, he'll say to himself, يَا وَيْلَتَ لَيْتَنِي لَمْ أَتَّخِذْ فُلَانًا خَلِيلًا. Shame on me twice. I shouldn't have taken this person as a khalil. And elsewhere Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الْخِلَّاءُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ إِلَّا الْمُتَّقُونَ. That the friends, the people who are so close to each other, most of them, these companions, they're going to be the losers. They're going to be enemies of each other on the Day of Judgment. Except those people who have the taqwa. Except the people of taqwa. So this person will say to himself, shame on me, I took this person as a close friend. لَقَدْ أَضَلَّنِي عَنِ الذِّكْرِ بَعْدَ الْجَأْنِي. He betrayed me and he sent me away from this message, away from the path after this message came to me. My brothers, this is something that we need to think about. Who are our friends? Who do we take as Khalil? Who do we take as our closest friends? Are they those people who, on the Day of Judgment, would have to flee from them? And we have to curse them because they started abandoning us and taking us away from the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ones who maybe take us away in good ways and in allowed ways, permissible ways, and in bad ways. Might be people who take us away by wasting our time. They'll say, shame on me. This person has taken me away and wasted my time. He took me away from this remembrance. And then the other message, this, wallahi my brothers, the messenger will say, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. My brothers, this is such a heavy verse. That the messenger will say on the Day of Judgment, in this conversation, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's calling out to Allah, that my people have taken this Qur'an al-Mahjur, they've abandoned this Qur'an. They've abandoned this Qur'an. My brothers, this is a serious statement that a Nabi will say. And this is something that we need to think about. Have I abandoned the Qur'an? Okay, in Ramadan I've been reading it, I've been listening to it in Taraweeh, I've been trying to listen to it more during the day. But how about after Ramadan? In the different aspects of the Qur'an. How much of the Qur'an am I reading on a day-to-day basis? Am I reading and having that close connection with the Qur'an on a daily basis? Am I memorizing the Qur'an? Am I trying to elevate my status in the hereafter by learning more of the Qur'an? Or have I left the Qur'an? And last year, this 12 months ago in Ramadan, I'm still at the same stage as I am now. My brothers, we need to ask ourselves these questions. How am I with the meanings of the Qur'an? What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in the Qur'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to us. This Qur'an that we hold, this is a spoken word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is something we need to have yaqeen. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke this Qur'an. And in a message for us, He's speaking to us. How have we taken this Qur'an? Have we abandoned this Qur'an, my brothers? We have tafsir classes here. Are we those who attend those, or have we abandoned the message of the Qur'an? How are we in terms of living the Qur'an, the akhlaq? How is our character? Have we abandoned the Qur'an because the Qur'an is not part of our character? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, خُلُقُهُ Al-Qur'an. In the hadith of Aisha radhiyallahu anha, she said his character Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the Qur'an. How is our character? How do we interact with the people? Are we the people of the Qur'an in terms of our characteristics and in our manners? The ones who Allah SWT says that they are his chosen people. How is our akhlaq, my brothers? This all the statement, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. Oh Allah, oh my Lord, that my people have taken this Qur'an, they have abandoned this Qur'an. My brothers, this is a serious verse that the Rasul will say in the Day of Judgment. And this is something for us, we need to think about this. And today, this might be Laylatul Qadr, or it was Laylatul Qadr. And some of the Salaf, they used to say that the day after, it carries the same amount of reward. Some of the Salaf, Imam Shafi'i amongst them, they used to say that the day of Laylatul Qadr, which might have been last night, might be the following nights as well. But the day has the reward as well. in this time now, my brothers, in Ramadan, make the intention that if we know that we are of those people who are close to being in the people who might have abandoned the Quran, make the intention now that this time next year, my brothers, this time next year, we won't be from those people who will be able to fall into this category. Make the intention of all the facets of the Quran, the reading, the memorizing, learning the meanings, what Allah SWT is telling me, how the Quran impacts my character, my conduct. We ask Allah SWT to make us from the people of the Quran, to allow us to become those people who read the Quran day and night, and to allow us to become those people who learn from the Quran and apply it in our lives, and those people who are able to become His the chosen people, and the ones who said to them, recite and elevate in Jannah. Because your status, your station in Jannah is upon the last verse that you recite. May Allah SWT increase us. Barakallahu feekum, subhanakallahu wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.